Griezmann shot 54% from the field, 53% from three-point in Sunday's win over Boston tonight. 53% from the field, 53% from three-point range. Anything stick out to you guys up here?
Well, the thing that sticks out to me is that surprisingly, the togetherness that they're playing with, you know, on the offensive side and the defensive side, just in terms of sharing the basketball. And we talk about the new guys that have come. You watch the Clarkson, you know, they got a body. George Hill's got a body on them. You know, it's dribble, handoff, shot, screen. You know, Hood knocks down the jump shot. And then, you know, just the ball movement and the hustle plays. Normally, this was only Tristan Thompson getting a basket like this. Now Nance gets one. Mm. And when was the last time LeBron James, someone created for him and made a shot for him? He was surprised when he was standing there.
Right.
He thought he was going to get a rebound.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, the ball was in his hand. He's like, oh, man, I got an easy layup. Now, he hasn't had an easy layup from one of his teammates.
All year.
Probably in like 2 years, right? So I like what they've done energy-wise, intensity-wise, ball movement. And it seems like they got good chemistry right now.
Seems like, BD, they're like they're at the Drew League having fun, just throwing it up there, getting it down. And I think that's what you want from a chemistry standpoint if you're the Cavs.
Absolutely, especially when you're playing with LeBron James. You know, as much as you can get out in the open court, get easy baskets, I think what helps them is, like Isaiah said, the defense. Now you got bigger guards. You got Nance, who's athletic, who can switch. You know, you get J.R. Smith back. You know, welcome back, J.R. Smith. It's good to see you back.
5 for 6 from 3-point line.
But now you got him and you got Rodney Hood, explosive scores. You got George Hill, who's steady. You know, it allows everybody else to go back to being who they were before all the new guys got there. And now with the new guys, they're young and complimentary because of their energy and their stickiness defensively.
Yeah, Shaq, what do you see on this ball move? I mean, we know you in the triangle. We know basically your favorite player in the world probably was turn 5. But what do you see with this ball move?
You know, in this era of basketball, the teams that move the ball quickly are the teams that are very successful. And what I like about these new guys is they know their role. You know, I'm going to take 2 or 3 dribbles, look to my guy. What does my guy like to do? You know, get the people to double team so he can kick it out. You know, he wants you to shoot right here, point forward. This is what he does. You know, call a play. Don't really look like they know the plays, but great ball movement right there. Great pass. And these guys definitely know their roles. They came into a new situation, but they know what they're supposed to do. Cleveland before the draft, I don't think people knew their roles. People complained about shots. People complained about not starting. But these guys done came in 2 games in a row shooting 53%. Playing together, having fun, rotating on defense. They look really good.
One of the things I used to like about you guys' offense in L.A., Shaq and those guys, the triangle, was that it kept certain players on the leash. So if you couldn't get too crazy because you know you were supposed to be here, center opposite this, it seems to me like LeBron has players that could play one-on-one but like playing off the ball better. You have to have guys that cut with integrity every time, even if they don't get the ball. And it just seems like with these players, he can play more of his game as a decoy.
Cut with
integrity. Because if you don't do that, because us playing against these guys.
Now, what does it mean when you say cut with integrity?
That means you got to trust me. You know B.D. Barron. I promise you, if you go through this, we playing Shaq and them, I promise you I'm going to get you a dunk. I'm going to get you layups, everything. But it might not be there. First quarter, if I don't see it, keep going. 3 times hard. Third quarter, second quarter. But I'm going to get you, and I'm going to get you nice. And if you don't cut like that, then the defense never honors you. It takes away from me. You can help play me and not guard him. And it just makes it a big mess. So you got to be able to cut hard each time. And it seems like these guys love playing with LeBron, love playing with, you know, the best player in the NBA. And they're going to do the little things just because they want to make that impact.
And, you know, and if we were to use a football analogy, that's what makes a great quarterback. When he has wide receivers that run their routes hard every single
time.
No matter what. Because sometimes, right, you may have a wide receiver who don't run that route hard, and it takes away from the other player. So cut with integrity. That's key word for tonight, right?
Yeah.
Cut with integrity and trust.
That's what's up.
I love that.
Good about yourself.
Nah,
you know what I mean? Make you feel like you know what you're talking about. And speaking of make you feel about yourself, BD, they out here. Shots fired.
Hey, man. Hey, the funny how. BD going viral. Don't be mad
funny?
You can't get on TV like me.
You think I'm funny?
You're entertaining?
You think I'm funny?
Funny how. I'm a joke?
I'm a joke, huh?
BD, he fresh. You don't know nothing about Versace. Versace. Hey. Back with more in a minute. A-Mix halftime report. You'd be good in that movie, though, man.
Welcome to the American Express Halftime Report American Express, the official card of the NBA.